The Philippine Weather Bureau warns dozens of provinces could still experience drought this May. Pagasa issued the advisory Thursday, even as it said the impact of the El Nino phenomenon continues to weaken. It said most of the provinces still likely to see drought are in Luzon, where many provinces contribute to the country's farming output. Pagasa still expects the transition from El Nino to neutral conditions happening between this month or by June. It also warns of a strong chance of La Nina or above normal rains developing in the second half of the year.
The Ombudsman junks the supplemental motion for reconsideration filed by former Budget Undersecretary Lloyd Christopher Lau. This is in relation to his alleged involvement in the anomalous purchase of COVID-19 test kits from formerly Pharmaceutical Corporation. Lau, who is facing graft charges, was the executive director of the procurement service of the Department of Budget and Management. The Ombudsman dismissed a motion stating that Lau failed to present new evidence he was not involved in the multi-million peso deal. The Ombudsman also found Pharmedy may have violated a Foreign Investment Act and anti-dummy law. It cited the presence of foreign nationals on the board of directors of Pharmedy, which is prohibited in small corporations.
The Philippine Trade Secretary urges manufacturers to consider a voluntary price freeze as the El Nino phenomenon hikes prices of essential goods. Local manufacturers and retailers told Secretary Alfredo Pascual they would be open to explore a price freeze to ease the burden on the public. Under the Philippine Price Act, areas under a state of calamity automatically freeze the prices of basic necessities for up to 60 days. As of end April, over 130 local government units have declared a state of calamity due to the impact of El Nino.
Good news awaits consumers next week with a fresh round of rollback in fuel prices in the offing. Early estimates show gas prices are down by over 2 pesos, while diesel and kerosene are down by over a peso. Industry players see the possible ceasefire in the Gaza war as a main driver of lower fuel prices.
The U.S. also pressing Israel to reopen the Rafah crossing and allow the entry of vital aid. The White House says choking off assistance to a population already on the brink of famine is unacceptable. Israel seized control of the Palestinian side of the border with Egypt Tuesday.
Ultimately, it's a question for Israel. Israel has seized that crossing and Israel is in control of it now. So it is Israel, the responsibility to open that crossing and make sure that it is running effectively right now is a responsibility of the government of Israel, which is why we have made clear to them that they need to open the crossing as soon as possible and make sure that aid deliveries can come in, make sure that humanitarian aid workers can come in and come out, and make sure that the delivery of humanitarian assistance isn't further impeded.
Israel's unrelenting offensive in Gaza has killed more than 34,800 Palestinians. This afternoon, 60 overseas Filipino workers from Israel arrived here in the Philippines. In total, 879 OFWs have returned home following the breakout of the war in Gaza.
Russia insists saying the war in Ukraine would be over in just 2 weeks if the West halts military supplies to Kyiv. Russian Foreign Ministry spokesperson Maria Zakharova also says it is the West that has raised the rhetoric about Moscow. Her remarks echoes those of European Union Foreign Policy Chief Joseph Borrell, who said earlier this month the war would be finished if the supply of Western weaponry ended. But Borrell also stressed he did not want the war to end like that.